1 year ago, my co-pastor Jill and I sat in this very place and told you about the strange and amazing opportunity we had to buy a big old church building in the heart of downtown Hamilton. And from that fundraising campaign, we were able to raise $100,000, which combined with some other fundraising through the year, has gotten us through the first stage of repairing and restoring this old space. We've restored the inside of the sanctuary, including drywall, mudding, and painting. The whole community gathered for a barn raising day where we cleaned and painted the back halls. We fixed a hole in the ceiling and the leaky roof that caused the hole. And we've done a lot of stuff that wasn't as noticeable. We stopped venting our hot water heater into the wall and rewired our electrical panels and upgraded our water service, which means our toilets actually flush now. We've poured new concrete and added a support beam and built basement stairs that aren't about to collapse. We upped our tech with cool-looking lights and smart thermostats powered by functional Wi-Fi and extra outlets. We've gotten tagged with graffiti about a dozen times, but have started responding to our taggers with our own graffiti. We painted a bunch of murals over things we couldn't afford to fix, some of which were really, really high up. We installed bike racks because there's no parking and started a garden and even got an awesome garbage holder. The entire side of the building has been repointed with mortar so that the bricks are no longer threatening to pop out at us. And maybe best of all, we had the old stained glass windows carefully removed piece by piece so they could be restored and reinstalled this fall. And the whole time this has been going on, we've been able to host amazing events in the building. Clothing swap pop-ups and neighborhood yard sales have done a great job helping us meet the neighbors. We've had art events and concerts and an interview with Canada's best rapper. We've hosted film and theology nights and a weekly co-working space and Thursday noon prayer and even a funeral for Jesus. And best of all, we've carried on the 125-year legacy of this space by ensuring that every week there's a community of people worshiping the risen Christ through sermons and an open table and music and mediocre coffee. Even better, there's now three communities worshiping in this space. There's the meeting house renting from us in the morning, the Romanian Baptist Church, who we bought the building off of, is here at night, and then we are smack dab in the middle at 3 p.m. We are just 1 year into having our own space, and we can already see how great it's gonna be. And so to everyone who gave last winter or throughout 2018, I just wanna say thank you. And while there's so much to celebrate in all of this, we still have a long way to go. So our hope for this leg of the fundraising is to fix the back hall windows, the front door that shattered, the back hall door, and the last set of stained glass windows. And the cost of these repairs is somewhere in the ballpark of $100,000. We are actively fundraising for a lot of this within our congregation, but we know that we can't do this alone. Whatever the tug is for you, I want to ask if you'd consider partnering with us in this project. In the description box below is a link to our fundraising page where you can see what we're currently raising towards and our progress so far. Every dollar you give will help us continue to repair and winterize this building and also contribute to the larger goal of making this building a place of worship for the next 125 years. Additionally, if you know anyone who would be interested in this whole thing, please pass this video on to them. We would love to have anyone else come alongside us and join us in this adventure. Oh, well, look who's here. I'm doing the 1 year update-y video thing.
Oh, terrific. Mm. Listen, we have had such a year working on this building. It has been amazing. And thank you to every single one of you who have contributed with helping us financially and helping us with time. And yeah. I'm really glad that you're still with us.
Thanks so much for being our partners in this. Grace and peace.
Grace and peace.